The Power of Nice by Linda Kaplan Thaler and Robin Koval. This audio version is published by Oasis Audio through an agreement with Currency Books, part of the Doubleday Broadway Publishing Group. The Power of Nice is read by Linda Kaplan Thaler and Robin Koval.
Foreword by Jay Leno. To me, one of the greatest books ever written is Charles Dickens' A Christmas Carol. Why? Because of its simple premise. Doing the right thing makes you feel better. It's not a religious thing. It's just that doing good things will improve your life. Let's face it, you can't eat the whole pie or you'll make yourself sick. Eat some and then give whatever is left over to other people. When I was asked to be interviewed for The Power of Nice, I said yes, not just because I wanted to be nice. I did so because I think it's the right way to be. But today being nice is so surprising it becomes a news story. I recently told a joke on the show and got a letter from a woman saying she was offended by it. I called her to apologize and say that I was sorry if I hurt her feelings. For some reason, she contacted the newspapers, and my apology became headline news. We live in a society where common courtesy is so uncommon that it is treated as though you just saved someone's life by giving them the Heimlich maneuver. Even if you get into an auto accident, insurance companies will tell you not to apologize. It's an admission of guilt. So what do they want you to do? Run away and call your attorney? Yet my guess is that if it's your fault and you do apologize, 9 times out of 10 people will be grateful and probably nicer back about getting the damage repaired. So many of today's problems can be solved with just simple acts of kindness. Being nice is especially important when you have a platform like The Tonight Show. It can't be a bully pulpit or an ego booster. There's a reason the show is called The Tonight Show with Jay Leno instead of The Tonight Show Starring Jay Leno. It's because of my mother. She thought saying Starring Jay Leno would tell audiences, "Oh, look at me, I'm a big shot." So I said to her, "Okay, Ma, how about with Jay Leno?" Life is not that hard. Try giving a little. You would be surprised at how much you get back.
Chapter 1, The Power of Nice. For years, we've loved a particular security guard in our Manhattan office building. In fact, most of us at the Kaplan Thaler Group think the world of him. A large, jovial man in his mid-50s, Frank brightens people's days by giving everyone who walks into our building a huge, warm greeting. "Hello, Linda. Hello, Robin," he'll say. "Happy Friday." Frank's engaging banter changed the way we started work in the morning. Instead of simply flashing our passes anonymously and making a beeline for the elevator, we found ourselves seeking out Frank and making sure to say hello. He set a positive tone for the entire day, but we never considered how Frank might be helping our business, other than preventing intruders from entering the premises. That is until the day Richard Davis, the president and COO of U.S. Bank, the 6th largest bank in the United States, came to see us. For months, our entire team at the Kaplan Thaler Group had been working to create a pitch that would wow Davis and win us the huge U.S. bank account. At the time of Davis's visit, it was down to the wire. We were one of 2 agencies still in the running for the account. Davis and his team were flying in from their executive offices in Minneapolis to meet personally with us. We didn't realize it at the time, but in fact, Davis and his staff were a bit apprehensive about the kind of treatment they'd get in New York City. The furious pace and hard-bitten, out-of-my-way attitude of the Big Apple had become part of the mythology of the city. They were afraid we would be too cold, too aloof. But when Richard Davis and his team walked into our building, they received a warm, enthusiastic greeting from Frank. When Davis reached our offices a few minutes later, he was gushing about the friendly security guard. "This guy gave me a huge hello," he said, and all of a sudden, I thought, how could I not want to work with a company that has someone like Frank? How can I feel anything but good about hiring an agency like that? We won the account. Of course, Davis wouldn't have awarded us the job if he wasn't impressed with our work. But we've got to give Frank credit. With a multi-million-dollar account in the balance, it was Frank's warm hello that helped us cinch the deal. That is the power of nice. The security guard wins the heart of the COO. It might sound like a Disney movie, but we can assure you it was no fantasy. We wrote The Power of Nice because we completely disagreed with the conventional wisdom that nice guys finish last and no good deed goes unpunished. Our culture has helped us to propagate the myth of social Darwinism, of survival of the fittest, that the cutthroat me versus you philosophy wins the day. One of the biggest selling career books in the past few years is called Nice Girls Don't Get the Corner Office. Yet this completely contradicts the way we have run our business and our lives. In less than a decade, we built the Kaplan Thaler Group into a powerhouse in advertising with close to $1 billion in billings, making it one of the nation's fastest growing advertising agencies. Our success was won not with pitchforks and spears, but with flowers and chocolates. Our growth is the result not of fear and intimidation, but of smiles and compliments. Time and time again, we have seen the extraordinary power of nice in our business dealings and in our personal lives. It's the patient passenger who politely asks the airline ticket agent to please check one more time who gets the first class upgrade, rather than the I'm a triple platinum member blowhard. It's the driver who is polite and apologetic to the police officer, who sometimes is forgiven for driving over the speed limit. But nice has an image problem. Nice gets no respect. To be labeled nice usually means the other person has little else positive to say about you. To be nice is to be considered Pollyanna and passive, wimpy and milquetoast. Let us be clear, nice is not naive. Nice does not mean smiling blandly while others walk all over you. Nice does not mean being a doormat. In fact, we would argue that nice is the toughest four-letter word you'll ever hear. It means moving forward with the clear-eyed confidence that comes from knowing that being very nice and placing other people's needs on the same level as your own will get you everything you want. Think about it. Nice is luckier in love. People who are low-key and congenial have one-half the divorce rate of the general population, says a University of Toronto study. Nice makes more money. According to Professor Daniel Goleman, who conducted research on how emotions affect the workplace for his book Primal Leadership, there is a direct correlation between employee morale and the bottom line. One study found that every 2% increase in the service climate, that is, the general cheerfulness and helpfulness of the staff, saw a 1% increase in revenue. Nice is healthier. A University of Michigan study found that older Americans who provide support to others, either through volunteer work or simply by being a good friend and neighbor, had a 60% lower rate of premature death than their unhelpful peers. Nice spends less time in court. One study found that doctors who had never been sued spoke to their patients for an average of 3 minutes longer than physicians who had been sued twice or more, reports Malcolm Gladwell in his book Blink, The Power of Thinking Without Thinking. It is often the small kindnesses, the smiles, gestures, compliments, favors, that make our day and can even change our lives. Whether you are leading your own company, running for president of the PTA, or just trying to conduct a civil conversation with your teenage daughter, the power of nice will help you break through the misconceptions that keep you from achieving your goals. The power of nice will help you to open doors, improve your relationships at work and at home, and let you sleep a whole lot better. Nice not only finishes first, those who use its nurturing power wind up happier to boot. In the chapters ahead, we'll show you that being nice doesn't mean sacrificing what you want for someone else. There's always a second, third, or even fourth solution when you apply the principles of nice. Chapter 2, The 6 Power of Nice Principles. The Power of Nice Principle Number 1, Positive Impressions Are Like Seeds. Every time you smile at a messenger, laugh at a coworker's joke, thank an assistant, or treat a stranger with graciousness and respect, you throw off positive energy. That energy makes an impression on the other person that in turn is passed along to and imprinted on the myriad others he or she meets. Such imprints have a multiplier effect, and ultimately those favorable impressions find their way back to you. That doesn't mean the waiter you tipped well will one day found a Fortune 100 company and offer you stock options, unless it was one heck of a tip. The results of the power of nice are rarely that direct. In fact, you may not notice any impact on your life for years, apart from the warm glow it gives you inside. Nonetheless, we have found that the power of nice has a domino effect. You may not ever be able to trace your good fortune back to a specific encounter, but it is a mathematical certainty that the power of nice lays the groundwork for many opportunities down the road. These positive impressions are like seeds. You plant them and forget about them, but underneath the surface, they're growing and expanding, often exponentially. Here's an example of how the power of nice has worked for us. Not long ago, we featured Donald Trump's wife, Melania, in an Aflac commercial at the suggestion of Aflac chairman and CEO Daniel Amos. We gave Mrs. Trump, as one of the stars of the commercial, her own trailer and made sure she was comfortable and had everything she needed. Our team treated her nicely not because she was married to a famous person, but because we have a policy of being polite and respectful to all the talent on our advertising shoots. Months later, the producers of The Apprentice asked Linda to be a judge on one of the shows in which The Apprentice hopefuls were required to create a car advertisement.
Before the first segment was shot, I introduced myself.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.